today we're going to be talking about the loop cut tool, what it is, why to use it, and how you can utilize it to make better models. Let's get into it. Loop cut is a tool that allows you to add complete rings around different parts of your mesh, provided that they are going across quads or, you know, four-sided polygons. The point of this really is so that you have more geometry to play with when you want to add elements to your mesh. So for example, I can now take this face and I can extrude it out. There is a second use for edge loops, and I'm going to show you what that is now. If I add a subdivision modifier to this, you can see that it goes quite rounded. But if I start adding edge loops to this, I then get more definition in those edges. The closer the edge loops go to zero, basically, or to the complete edge, the tighter those corners get. So edge loops are good for adding geometry, and they're especially important for constraining existing geometry if you want to help define the shape as you subdivide, as we can see here. If you want to use the loop cut tool, then you go to this icon here on the side menu bar inside of edit mode. Just select an edge there, but when you click on this, it allows you to choose a loop cut to add. Your other option is to hold Control R, and then that will bring up the ability to add a loop cut using the shortcut as well. Okay, and then you left click once again to place that edge. There is a secondary function inside of loop cut that I wanted to make you aware of. Let's add our loop cut there. Let's hold down the left mouse button and drop it on offset edge loop cut. What happens now is if we click and drag, you see we get two opposing edge loops which appear out of it. Works very similar to the extrude edge function inside of 3D Studio Max. And this could be handy because when I drop that, I can now do something with this geometry. Maybe I want to take this edge, for example, and I want to scale it in because I want a bit of a pinch, and I want to add that because I'm creating some kind of tower or pipe of some kind. But once again, it's also very good for just constraining edges. So if I was to, let's say, add an edge loop here and add an edge loop up here, I wouldn't necessarily have to do it that way. I could just add the edge loop there, go over here, offset edge loop, pull those down, and then I can just push them to the edges there. And then if I add a modifier and subdivision on this, we have this edge here, and we have this edge here, and those are constraining this edge and this edge. And because of that, we're getting nice sharper edges, and then we can select this, move it down to make it tighter, or move it up to make it softer. You know, maybe you want to make some kind of salt shaker or something like that, maybe. So, you know, you wanted to turn this into a lamp perhaps, so you know, we could select this edge, bring it up further, select these, we could add another couple of edge loops in there maybe, or something like that, and then maybe one there, maybe one there, maybe one up here. And then what we could do, select the edge here, go to proportional editing, which we actually talked about in the first video, and we could scale, no, that's not the one I wanted, then we could scale that out maybe, scale that in, sorry, I meant to say. So yeah, we're going for that salt shaker look. Let's choose loop cut, let's place a loop code there. Now we've got our box here, which allows us to change elements about what we've added here. So for example, I can change the number of cuts I've made. I've got one at the moment, but I can scale that up to whatever number I want. Let's put that to 2 for the time being. I can change the smoothness to how smooth I want it to be. I can also change the fall off so that if I was to extrude or set in these loop cuts, then I can choose a particular shape, such as if it's spherical, if it's quite smooth, if it's quite sharp. I want to choose the sharp profile, okay? But I also want to bring you to these as well. It always has the edge extensor clamped. I would advise you keep that on. I'd advise that you keep correct UVs on so that UVs are maintained wherever possible. There's no real need to flip edge loops in most cases, so I wouldn't bother with this at the moment. But even is quite important, and I'll show you what I mean. If I want to set these edges in, if I were to do it right now, okay, it's just affecting the whole shape. And maybe I want that, maybe if I want to turn this into a candlestick, okay? But I don't, I want to set those in, okay? So let's, they've gone, brilliant. So let's set those in. What I need to do is add 2 more edge loops around these edges to constrain them, as we said before. But maybe I want to use the offset edge loop to do that. So if I do that with this one, for example, and I pull it up, you see that? This one goes much higher than this one here. And the reason being for that is the distance between these two edge loops is much smaller than these two. So it's always set unevenly. What you should do is click even, and then you should play around with the factor here, okay? Which if you bring that down in this particular case, you can get them quite close by. If you find that a bit fussy, what you can do is just select your edge loop, go back to loop cut, and you can just add them manually. So you'll still get a similar effect. So now, when I go to my edge loops and I select them, then I scale inwards, I'm getting this quite interesting effect. Getting quite a curved edge here. We're getting sharp edges here and here, or sharper bevels and chamfers. And the reason being for that is because of the distance between edges, okay? And because we set this edge loop here and this edge loop here, maybe if I select them, that will help you a bit more, okay? We selected one, we added this one here, added this one here, and this one here, using the offset edge loop cut tool. There's a lot more that you could do with that model. I'm just going to leave it here for now. It's just to give you a basic idea of how loop cut works, what offset edge loop cut is, why it's important for adding geometry to your mesh so you can make changes like we did with this section, and why it's important for constraining elements of your mesh so you get the smoothness and edges you want when you subdivide. Hope it was useful. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.